Howdy, hi campers, hope you're all doing well. Well, I'm back out for a camp. My rucksack weighs a ton. The weather is miserable. It's that rain, it's not chucking it down, but it's that fine drizzly stuff that soaks you through. It's horrible. And the wind's blowing a bit of a hoolie too. I'm just in a sheltered bit of woodland at the minute, protected from a lot of the wind, so I can hear it blowing across the top of me. I thought I'd say hello to you, take a moment to have a little bit of a breather. Should be an interesting camp. As soon as I get to my spot, I'm gonna tarp up straight away, so I probably won't film that bit because I just want to get a shelter up and sorted. But I knew the weather was gonna be like this. So I've got my canvas tarp so I can have a fire underneath the canvas and make life a bit more comfortable. So yeah, should be good fun. Should be a challenge getting a fire going in these conditions, but that's all part of it, isn't it? So I'll bring you back in a bit and let's get to it. Oh. It's been a while since I did a bit of filming, but the weather's been howling. I got here and Chris was here under his tarp, the firebox burning, so that was a nice bit of relief. And nice and warm under the tarp here. Thanks for sorting that out, Chris.
Yeah, no worries, mate.
So I've just got my tarp up over there, hunkered it down a little bit because the wind is blowing through. So hopefully things will settle down later and I'll bring you back then. Party high campers, so I've got some sausages on the go at the moment on Chris's firebox. Chris is over there making up some pizza.
Yeah man.
On the Trangia. He's just made me one. He's done it with some little mini naan breads. He made an oven sort of set up in the Trangia there. So look at that, that looks alright, that does.
Taste test.
Thank you very much, sir.
No worries.
Ooh. It's hot, isn't it? Sorry if you just had to watch that. That's really nice, Chris.
A nice taste to it, isn't it?
Got a little bit of spice on it, I like that.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Nice.
That's not bad for a coffee drinker.
See what do so I get up the float.
Like this for the rest of the day now, hopefully. Although the temperature is supposed to plummet later on. Got me wax canvas tarp there. Haven't put the bed out yet, but I'll do that later. Just got some wood gathered under there to have a fire bowl later. So I think I'm gonna have a fire under the tarp, just a small one. To keep some warmth in, so that'll be quite nice. And I'll process those sticks down later into a nice little pile and fire up the fire a little later on tonight. Just had some sausages, an egg, and a bit of pizza that Chris made. Really nice, that was. I thoroughly recommend trying it. Hopefully the weather stays a bit more settled now because it's been bloody wet. there we go then. Should keep me going for a while. I've got the 5-hour in the middle there. It's going to keep the fire nice and small, so you can't be silly under a tarp. There we go then, folks. A bit more organised underneath the tarp now. I've got the fire organised there. Bivy bag, I've just chucked it in there. British Army bivy bag with my Rab 2-season sleeping bag. There's my rucksack there. It's the Virtus 40 litre day set. British Army issue, that one. I've got my sleeping pad over there underneath Chris's tarp. I'll move that across later. I'm sitting on it at the moment. Yeah, so it's quite liking that setup actually there. Should be quite cosy later. Hi campers, so I'm under my wax canvas tarp now. I don't think that's coming up too well when the camera there. It's the GoPro for you, I'm afraid. But got the fire in the UCO fire bowl there. Got a nice stack of wood either side of the fire pit. And got the candle burning as well. The light. And adjust that a little bit. There we go. Hopefully you can see me. Fire's just getting started up again there. But Chris has just left me for the night now. He's walking back to his truck. Great to see Chris as always, and sample some of the lovely pizza he cooked up in the oven on his Trangia. That was really nice. I'm gonna definitely try that for myself. The weather's been absolutely awful today. It's rained a heck of a lot. It's been really blowing and blowy and windy throughout most of the day. But I've got to tell you, under the tarp here, it's a little bit smoky at the moment whilst the fire gets going. So I've just put a load of fresh wood on there. Not fresh, a load of slightly damp wood on there. But it'll get going in a moment and the smoke will clear. But it is lovely and warm underneath here, and you go outside the tarp and it's actually quite chilly. So I'm gonna sit here for a bit. It's only, what was it, 5:20, so time's getting on. I'll do dinner soon and I've got a couple of beers to enjoy. But yeah, a nice camp in testing conditions, and at the moment I feel like I'm winning. Yeah, I'm sorry there's not been much footage up until now. I've just been chilling out under Chris's tarp, sitting around his firebox, chatting to him. And I've got to say, kudos to the firebox there that Chris was using. He had that burning from 6 a.m. when he, or thereabouts when he got here, right up until, well, just now, and it's just gone 5 o'clock in the evening. So it's done a good old shift, that firebox, it's been absolutely flawless. Really impressed with that. Might have to sell one or two of my stoves and buy one now, I think. Very tempting. But yeah, I'll bring you back when something interesting's happened. I think it's just worth making a quick point on the fire here. Fact that it's underneath my tarp. I'm using a wax canvas tarp, and I brought it to this camp specifically because I knew the weather was going to be foul, and it's safe to have a fire underneath a canvas tarp. It's spark resistant naturally spark resistant. You can have fires like this underneath your sort of steel nylon tarps, more plasticky tarps, but do so at your own risk. You can potentially burn a hole or two from the sparks in the fabric in those tarps, so yeah, you can risk damaging your tarp. But I do so underneath the wax canvas tarp, knowing that it's completely spark resistant, and there's also plenty of good airflow here as well. So the back of the tarp is into the wind
and there's ventilation from three sides in here as well. I'm getting a bit of smoke in a minute, but as soon as that fire kicks off, it will clear very quickly. But yeah, just a note of caution really about having fires underneath your tarps. Be very careful. And I'm keeping that fire under sort of tight control as well. I'm only putting small sticks on it, nothing significant. And then I shall make sure the fire's extinguished before I go to bed. I don't need to keep that burning through the night. And I especially don't want any sparks coming off of that and hitting my bivy bag, because that will burn a little hole in the bivy. Alright folks, so tea time. Just had a bit of bacon that you saw me cooking in the last clip. That was a bit of a leftover from lunch that I didn't cook, so I just had that as a little bit of a aperitif. And then for dinner, I've got something you've seen me do a few times before now. It's a bit of a cowboy stew. I've got baked beans, a bit of chorizo sausage, and then in here I've got a mini baby bell cheese, and then some mushrooms and onion that I've cut up. Red onion from the allotment, actually, I might add. And I've got a potato here, which I think I'm going to chop up and part boil in the pot, in the billy pot, and then chuck it in with the rest, stew it all up. So I think I'm going to do that. Before I do anything else, folks, I thought I'd just show you this little pouch that I got off Dave Fry's a while back now. It's a wax canvas pouch. Just holds your essentials. So I've got a little Swiss Army knife in here, ferrocerium rod, lighter, and a torch as well. All the essentials for a camping trip. But one thing I'm thinking about doing soon, folks, is going really minimal with a camp. Absolutely. Just keeping everything nice and simple, and just using this little pouch here in my pocket as the sort of as my tools for the camp, really. So leaving the axe and the knife and the saw and everything at home, just seeing how much I can achieve just by using this little bag of tools. I think that could be quite good fun. Let me know what you think, or if you think it would be worth making a video about it. Doobie-doo. Whilst dinner's going, folks, I thought I'd crack open a beer. And this one my wife picked for me because she thought the graphics on it were quite cool. It's a bit of a campfire scene there. And this is a German, oh, Danish brewery, beg your pardon. Is it? No, it's not. No, of course it's not. Manchester. What am I on about? That's an Imperial Campfire Porter. No idea what that means. 10%. It's called Wander Beyond Brewing. Oops. A little explosion. Oh. Well, that's not bad, that. Beer all over my hands, though. Yeah, check out that scene. I love that. Very cool. So thank you. Thank you, Mrs. Bimbles. Still be- Beanie. Chew it, so you loveliness. Lovely. Just get in my belly. I had a bit of a boo-boo with the potatoes, folks. I got them boiled up, and as I was draining off the water, I dropped the pot, and the spuds went everywhere. So this is without the spuds, but hey-ho, never mind. It's still tasty, and still full of sustenance. Hi campers, so I've had dinner, just been chilling out for a bit, checking in with the good lady wife. Got another beer and a go now from Moot Brewery, which is very local to this area. It's only about a couple of miles away actually. Yeah, very nice it is too. This one is called Butter. But yeah, just enjoying the fire, the warmth of it as well. Nipped out from the top for a wee earlier, and it is blooming cold outside, away from the fire. So I'm gonna keep this fire going for a little while. Yeah, I think it's only 20 to 8. I'll be staying up a little while yet before I get into bed. And then I'll let this fire go out beforehand for sure. But yeah, it's nice having the fire so close. Been good to get out though. It's funny how your priorities change a little bit when the weather sort of goes against you. I came out today sort of, well, I was preparing initially to sort of try and be a bit crafty and get some things done around camp, do a bit of whittling and practice some skills and whatnot. But when the sort of weather goes against you, your priorities shift to one, a position in which you want to sort of sustain yourself whilst you're out here. Make sure you're comfortable, make sure you've got everything you need, such as the fire. And all your shelter is absolutely on point and giving you the important shelter and warmth that you need. And then once you've got that settled, you can sort of relax a little bit then. But thereafter, I spend most of my time chatting away with Chris, catching up with him, which as always is a pleasure. Yeah, I haven't got too much to report into you guys really. I apologise, this is probably a bit of a boring video. There we go then, folks. Tucked up in the bivy bag now. Nice and warm. Moved the fire away from the under the tarp now. It's just over there smouldering away. By morning time that should be nice and extinguished, and I'll be able to disperse the ashes. Clean up, leave no trace. But you know what? Full disclosure, sometimes when you're camping like this in a tarpon bivvy, can be a bit of a faff bedding down for the night. You know, stripping down your clothes, putting your long johns on, changing socks, getting in the bivvy bag, getting comfortable and zipped up. It can feel like a bit of a marathon getting that all done. And then once you get settled in, you get in your bivvy bag, your sleeping bag, you get comfortable, you think, oh, I need to go for a wee. And that hasn't happened to me tonight, but other nights I've done that, got all comfortable, had that need to go for a wee, and I've had to get back out, go for a wee, and do it all over again. It's a pain in the backside sometimes. But this is what we sign up for. This is all part of the fun. So on that token, I'll bid you good night, and I'll bring you back in the morning. So bye for now. Morning all.
Well, it was a chilly night, but it was nice. Got a good night's sleep then. I think I might have found the limits of this sleeping bag last night. This is my Rab one. My Rab Solar 2, this sleeping bag. And it's got a comfort rate of -1. And I think it was in sort of low single digits last night, the temperature, but there was a big sort of wind chill factor in there as well though, which probably brought it down. And I definitely probably found the limits for the bag here. Although I was warm and comfortable, you could feel the sort of chill starting to get through. But got me through the night, so I can't complain. I need to get a brew on now, I think. Gasping for a cup of tea. So I've got my modified BCB burner with me, the Fire Dragon one, and I've adapted it to use it with a methylated spirit burner now. Got Neil Greencraft's burner here. All I've done is flatten down the fuel tablet compartment so that the spirit burner sits in there. Let's get it going. Folks, so just had a brew now. As you can see, I've been packing away camp. And what I thought I'd do, because I've used the new rucksack for this camp, I've used the British military issue Virtus 40 litre day sack. And what I thought I'd do is I'll show you how I load that up with all the kit that I've got organised here in a bit of a mess. And I'll show you how it rolls. In all the dry bags here, I've got all clothing, shelter, sleep system packed away. Sleeping mat, as you can see. I've left my brew kit out there. I won't pack that away just yet because I still want to have some porridge before I leave. But yeah, what I'll do is I'll rig you up in the tripod and show you how I do it. Right, so the first thing I'm going to do is fill out the inside a bit. Got my dirty old waterproofs here, which I used yesterday, so I'm just going to stuff them down the bottom. They're dry now because I haven't worn them for quite a while now. Then I've loosely wrapped the sleeping bag in here. I'll go down and then I'll roll it around. Spare clothing and hat, gloves, etc. I'm wearing a hat, but you know what I mean. That goes next to the sleeping bag. As you can see, there's quite a wide load capacity there, which I think is quite handy. Got my fire anchor here, which I'm going to slide down the side of it. Starts to give the rucksack a bit of form then, because this hasn't got a frame in it. You can buy frames for these rucksacks, but I haven't got one. Axe goes down a side here, and there's a little pocket at the bottom that it slips into. Lovely. Right, what's next? Bivy bag, I think. Yeah, bivy bag I've packed away in the dry bag here. That sits on top of the sleeping bag. Kushti. Then what I should pack next is my Swan Dry. I'll just go in the top there. And then here I've got my frying pan, and that's my fire bowl, which I was very impressed, nests neatly there into it. Pushing that all down. I've got an empty water bottle. Sliding that down the front a little bit. Candle lantern. Normally when I'm planning my camps, I pack it an awful lot better. Cordage and pegs at the top. And there we go, I'm getting there now. And here is my tarp. I'm not bothering to do up the dry bags because nothing's really wet, to be honest. So I'll do up that collar. So that's the main compartment almost done.
In the top here.
The one bit that is wet is my ground sheet that I've slept on. So that'll go in the sort of snow flap area. And there we go. On the top lid here you've got an inside pocket. So I'm just going to pop my first aid kit in there. And then you've got two further pockets on the top as well here. You've got one at the back, which I'm going to put my knife and saw into. And battery pack. When I'm packing up to go home, everything just gets slung in. Just do that up. I won't do that. Just see what I do now. I'll show you how the clamshell opening works for this. So you unclip these compression straps. And there's a zip that goes around, and you can see how everything is packed inside them. I can tidy things up a little bit, and I've got a pocket here now as well which I can use, and in there I'm going to put this little ground mat that you can get. I got off David Fryer's. Slips down there nicely. I love a ground mat, as you can see. Zip that up. There we go. Push deep. Oh yeah, I've got some bits here left. These are empty silicone pouches that I put food in. There's a rubbish bag there which I can chuck in. And there we go. Before I do the top pouch up, what I can do next is I've got a lovely pouch down the bottom here, and in there normally goes my sleeping pad. Right. you around. And there we go. All that's left is my food, drink, brew kit there. And that will occupy both side pouches because they're both still empty. Plenty of room for them. Happy days. All in all, it's a really nice rucksack. I'm really pleased with it. It's 50 litres including the two side pouches. Ample room for an overnight camp, or even longer actually, I think. Yeah, really enjoyed using that. You'll see a lot more use, I think. So there you go. So there we go then, folks. All cleared away. Took my rubbish away as well. It's in the bag, as you saw. And just moved over here now to this spot where the fallen tree is to sit on. And yeah, just got a brew on the go there. I've got waterboarding for another cup of tea and a bit of porridge. But yeah, that probably wasn't the best showcase of the rucksack that I've just filmed, but yeah, really impressed with it. Really like the way it carries and loads up. And yeah, look forward to using that a bit more. Nice camp. It's been a challenging camp with the weather conditions, but it's always good to have a challenge from time to time. Enjoyed it, enjoyed some good food, catching up with Chris. I was hoping to do a bit more sort of crafty stuff, a bit of carving and whatnot, practice a few more sort of fire lighting skills, but this time probably was just all about sort of staying warm and comfortable really. So yeah, I didn't get a chance, but never mind. It's good to get out anyway, and I'll be back out again soon, and I'll be sure to bring you along. So hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I'll bid you farewell. Bye for now.